Hi, and welcome to a bite-sized tutorial. Would you like to make your buttons look like this? Or this? Or what about this? I will be using DoTween, so if you don't already have it in your project, it's available for free on the Asset Store, link in the description. Now, let's first create a new script. The name doesn't matter, so let's call it Custom Button Base. Double-click on the script to open it up in your editor. I'll just quickly clean this up and remove the start and the update method. Up here, after mono behavior, we need to add the following: iPointer enter handler, iPointer click handler, and iPointer exit handler, all separated by commas. I'm using Rider as my editor and I can immediately see that something is missing. If I hover over this, we can see that the interface members are not implemented. Now, depending on your editor, this could look different, but you'll most likely find a light bulb somewhere next to this line. Click on it, choose Implement Missing Members, and these methods will be added automatically. Now, these may be self-explanatory, but code in these methods will be fired when the cursor enters the button, when the player clicks, and when the cursor exits again. In our first example, when the cursor enters the button, it scales up, and when it leaves, the button scales back to its original size again. So let's start by recreating that. Let's make sure these methods are cleaned up before continuing. Now, because I'll be showing variants of our custom button, I'll just extend this. This means I can have one that scales, one that changes color, and one that has a background image that fades in and out. Or maybe one that does all of the above. Let's first add the keyword abstract between public and class. Now, between public and void for the methods, add the keyword virtual. Jump back into Unity and create a new script. Let's call this one custom button scale. Open up the script, and instead of deriving from mono behavior, type custom button base. This is the script we will attach to the button we want to scale, and we have access to the methods in the custom button base class. Remove the start and the update methods, we don't need those. Let's start with the onPointerEnter method. Your code editor will most likely autocomplete this, so type onPointerEnter, press return, and it should override the method from the custom button base class. This line here means that anything you have in the original method in the base class will be fired here. You can test this by adding a debug log in the original method. Something you'd have in the original methods would be things applicable for all types of buttons, such as playing audio when clicking, or changing the cursor icon when hovering over the button. This way you'd only have to write the code once, in the base class, and not repeat it for every button. And if you need to update something, you only have to change it once. Now, let's write code for actually scaling the button on hover. In the top here, type using dg.tweening. Let's add a private variable of type float called originalScale and make it a constant with the keyword const here. You can already assign a value to this, so set it to 1. Also, add a private float called toScale and make the field serialized, serialized field within square brackets, to easily update the value in the inspector. And finally, serialized field followed by private float duration. Now, in the onPointerEnter method, type transform.doScale, and within the parentheses, we first need the end value as the first argument, toScale, followed by duration. Let's also set the easing, so on the next line type .setEase, and for the argument type ease.inOutSign. End this with a semicolon. Let's just quickly try this out in Unity. Right-click in the hierarchy and find the button under UI. Let's clean this up a bit by removing the image and setting the transition to none. Drag the custom button scale script onto the button and set the scale to 1.1 and the duration to 0.15. Hit play, and if we now move our cursor over the button, we should see that 1, the button scales up, and 2, here in the console, we can see our message from the base class. Everything seems to be working, but the button doesn't scale back when exiting yet. Open up the scale script again and let's have a look at our scaling here. You can also remove the debug.log now, since we know that it's working. Now, add an onPointerExit method as we did up here. You can just copy this doScale method and paste it in the onPointerExit method, but change the end value here to originalScale. Save your script and jump back into Unity. Now, when you hover over the button, it scales up. When you leave, it goes back to its original scale. Simple! Now, let's have a look at how to change the color of our button. Start by creating a new script, call it custom button color. Again, we are not deriving from Mono behavior, but from our custom button base class. We can start off by adding two lines up here, using dg.tweening and using tmpro. Remove the start and the update methods, and let's move on to some variables. First, a private tmp text called button text. Next, a private color called original color. We also need a private color called toColor, but make the field serialized. Assign a default value to it. I'll just go with black as a fallback. And finally, a serialized private float called duration. Add an awake method and let's assign the button text by typing button text equals get component in children with tmp text within angle brackets. This will just pick the first, and in our case the only text object in our button. Also, set the original color to buttonText.color. Now, as we did in the scale script, we need to override both onPointerEnter as well as onPointerExit. It's not too different from the scale script, so in the onPointerEnter method type buttonText.doColor. And as the first argument, type toColor, and the second one is your duration. And again, set the easing to inOutSign. Copy this and paste it into the onPointerExit method, but change the first argument to originalColor. Jump back into Unity and create a new button as we did before. Remove the image, set the transition to none, and drag the color script onto your button. Set the duration to 0.15 and change the color. Hit play, and when you hover over the button, the text color changes. Let's now recreate the last one. Start by creating a new button, repeat our previous steps, but also add an image as a child of the button. Place it behind the text object. Resize it to your liking, and on the color here, set the alpha channel to 0. Create a new script, call it custom button background. Open up the script, make sure it derives from custom button base, and include dg.tweening in the top here. Clean up your script and let's add some variables. Private image background image, and a serialized private float called duration. Add an awake method and type background image equals get component in children and image within angle brackets. Again, onPointerEnter and onPointerExit. In the onPointerEnter method, type background image.doFade, where the first argument is 1, followed by duration. Also, set the easing as we did before, .setEase and ease.inOutSign. Copy this into the onPointerExit method, but change the end value, the first argument, to 0. Basically, this will make the background image fade to 1 on enter and back to 0 on exit. Back in Unity, drag the new script onto your button and set the duration to 0.5. Hit play and test this out. I can now change the color of the background image. Since the background image is a bit dark, the text almost disappears. You know what we could do? Drag the color script onto the button as well. Set its duration to the same, 0.5, and set the color to something brighter. Hit play, and now the background image fades in, and the text color changes at the same time. And there you have three different buttons, all of which you can combine however you wish. If you have any other examples of buttons you'd like to see how they could be recreated, let me know down in the comments section, and I'll try my best to help you. The code can be found on my GitHub page, linked down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.